And it says showtime. You are live. Play that funky music, Chief X, for the occasion, right? This is a song for the occasion. And when this song go off, we will go in and we will talk about it. Listen here, family. I'm about to have fun tonight. God damn it. People may be mad at me after I make this spiel. But oh, goddamn well, it needs to be said. I love you still. God damn it. But listen here. Listen to Chief X. I'm telling you.
Some good ass weed.
Check it out, dog. This game is a motherfucking trip, man. Word on the streets. Everybody always try to run up on me, holler my word on the streets. This nigga said this. Man, I don't give a fuck about what that nigga said, man. That's what's wrong with you niggas. You niggas are just like bitches. Whole ass niggas. Talk too motherfucking much.
Speak.
Stay to your own. Get your own. You know what I'm saying? Be independent, nigga.
Bitch.
Yeah. Bitch niggas. Bitch niggas. Bitch ass niggas. Bitch niggas. Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Bitch niggas.
You too. Dog. I meet more bitch niggas than hoes. Look here. And I really don't know. But that's just how I go. Dog. So many niggas like to keep up shit. And just like a bitch, niggas be talking shit. Smiling in my face and then they blast me in the back. Niggas stay strapped from way back, cause payback make niggas wanna pop that shit. If you ain't ready for the game, niggas stop that shit. We rock that shit. My nigga Dre, drop that shit. No more talking, I'm walking and I'm popping the clip. Glock on the hip, set tripping, dipping and shit. If you act like a bitch, nigga, you get smacked like a bitch. Bitch niggas. Bitch niggas.
These niggas don't know what the fuck is going on. Yo, dog, check it, kick back. Let me holler at these niggas for a minute.
Straight off the streets of chaos and no pity. The aggravated, making these punk motherfuckers hate it. Compton is the city I'm from. Can't never leave the crib without a murder weapon. I can't live my life on broke no more. And most of these fools ain't shit but cutthroats. They smile in the nigga face. And for what? They got the game fucked up and want my thing fucked up. I done learned a lot, seen a whole lot. The top notch nigga, I'm fiendin' for that spot. Now peep game on what six dudes told me.
These niggas after your paper, Dr. D-R-E. And these punk ass hoes is looking for dough. You gotta watch your homeboys, cause a nigga never know. Oh, they'll be around, but when your paper get low, just like Master P said,
there they go, there they go, there they go. Bitch, bitch niggas. Niggas.
Bitch nigga, use a bitch nigga. Holla, a bitch nigga, a bitch nigga.
I know your type, so much bitch in you. If it was slightly darker, lights was little dimmer, my dick be stuck up in your windpipe. You rather blow me to fight. I'm from the old school, like Romy Rome, homie. Yo, you owe me the right to slap you like the bitch that you are. Been wanting to cap you ever since you was mad dogging me with that bitch in your car. Fool, who do you think you are? Mr. Big Stuff, man, you shit on hit, get your shit bust. Plus, pistol whip, cover it up, use your bitch's blush. Mr. Powder Puff, yo, bark ain't loud enough, huh? I know chihuahuas, that's more rah-rah. Ha-ha, I have to laugh, Dre. I bet he take bubble baths. You don't want no trouble with the aftermath staff. Trust me, doggy dog, diggy doctor plus me. No, use a buster slash hussy, soft as a hush puppy. Must we break you down to estrogen? Most hated specimens of bitch, nigga.
Stop scheming and looking hard.
Stop scheming and looking hard. And looking hard. And looking hard. And looking hard.
Oh man, oh man, Say so, say so. Hold on, y'all. Hold on, I'm coming.
Good ass weed.
Check it out, y'all.
I'm coming. Hold on.
Trip, man. Word on the streets. Everybody always try to run up on me, hollering my word on the streets. This nigga said this. Man, I don't give a fuck about what that nigga said. That's what's wrong with you niggas. You niggas are just like bitches. Whole ass niggas. Talk too motherfucking much.
Speak.
Stay to your own. Get your own. You know what I'm saying?
Be independent, nigga.
Bitch, nigga. Get your own. You know what I'm saying? Be independent, nigga.
Bitch.
Get your own. Get your own. You know what I'm saying? Be independent, nigga.
Bitch.
Get your own. Get your own. You know what I'm saying? Be independent, nigga.
Bitch.
Bitch, nigga. Bitch, nigga. Bitch ass nigga.
Bitch, nigga.
Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Bitch, nigga.
You too. Dog. I meet more bitch niggas than hoes. Look here, and I really don't know, but that's just how I go. Dog. So many niggas like to keep up shit. And just like a bitch, niggas be talking shit. Smiling in my face and then they blast me in the back. Niggas stay strapped from way back, cause payback make niggas wanna pop that shit. If you ain't ready for the game, niggas stop that shit. We rock that shit, my nigga Dre, drop that shit. No more talking, I'm walking and I'm popping the clip. Glock on the hip, set tripping, dipping and shit.
If you act like a
bitch, nigga you get smacked like a bitch. Bitch nigga, bitch nigga.
These niggas don't know what the fuck is going on. Yo, dog, check it, kick back. Let me holler at these niggas for a minute.
Straight off the streets of chaos and no pity. The aggravated, making these punk motherfuckers hate it.
Compton is the city I'm from.
Can't never leave the crib
without a murder weapon.
I can't live my life on broke no more. And most of these fools ain't shit.
But cutthroats, they smile in a nigga face. And for what?
They got the game fucked up and want my thing fucked up. I done learned a lot, seen a whole lot. The top notch nigga, I'm fiending for that spot. Now peep game on what six dudes told me.
These niggas after your paper, Dr. D.R.E. And these punk ass hoes
is looking for dough. You gotta watch your homeboys, cause a nigga never know. Oh, they'll be around, but when your paper get low, just like Master P said, there they go,
bitch niggas.
Bitch nigga, he's a bitch nigga. A bitch nigga, bitch nigga. A bitch nigga. I know your type, so much bitch in you. If it was slightly darker, like a little dimmer, my dick be stuck up in your windpipe. You rather blow me than fight. I'm from the old school, like Romy Rome, homie. Yo, you owe me the right to slap you like the bitch that you are. Been wanting to cap you ever since you was mad dogging me with that bitch in your car. Fool, who do you think you are?
Mr. Big Stuff,
man, you shit on hit, get your shit bust. Plus, pistol whip, cover it up, use your bitch's blush. Mr. Powder Puff,
your bark ain't loud enough.
I know
chihuahuas, that's more rah-rah.
Ha-ha, I have to laugh, Dre, I bet he take bubble baths. You don't want no trouble with the aftermath staff, trust me. Doggy dog, diggy doctor plus me. No, use a buster slash hussy, soft as a hush puppy. Must we break you down to estrogen, most hated specimens of bitch niggas.
All right. Enough of that funky stuff. People talking about Chief X up out here looking high as a kite. Let me be honest with you. I've been drinking some whiskey tonight and watching a Laker game. I've been having a sports night and doing my thing. But trust and believe, Chief X is always coherent, right? I wouldn't even go live if I was incoherent. But I do got me a nice little buzz on. I'm sitting here having some whiskey. You know, I got a mix of some Jack Daniels, Tennessee honey, right? And I mix it were little cheap ass doers. And I'm just in a good move. The pseudo killers is breaking up. They arguing about a bunch of dumb and bullshit, about a bunch of dumb shit. And we're gonna talk about it tonight. I had to block Uncle Shug's bitch ass for the first time. I gave the nigga a reprieve and allow him to comment in my chat, but the nigga just couldn't keep it respectful. So I had to block the bitch ass nigga. For good. Alright, alright. So, you know what? These pipes, right? Sometimes when you inhale, you gotta kind of shake out, because it'll get a little saliva built up in there. And when you... Wait a minute, let me see if you can see. You have these spots. And I don't know if it's just precipitation or the, you know, when you blowing it. I don't know. But every now and then, you gotta shake it off. Peace to the chat. FSK, peace to you. Markel, Maxwell, peace to you. OG Steve Wilkos up in here. The OG Squally Vision up in here. Lil Narm, we say DJ Chiefin. I like that, Lil Narm. Whatever Lil Narm stands for. Is that Lil Narmer? I did a video on Narmer the other day. OG Donnie Williams steps up in the spot. Armchair Philosopher, one of my wisest followers, right? OG, excuse me, Armchair Philosopher, right? OG Donnie, say cheers up. Cheers to you, Donnie Williams. Uncle Shug talking that shit, right? It's about to go down. What'd he say? Chief X definitely high as fuck tonight. All right, OG Stoic up in here, Astro 87, Eric Christopher. He say X getting it in. God damn it. Good evening to you, BB Rodriguez. Astro 87, Akasuda. Fuck, he said Egyptians never traded with the Mediterranean civilizations. Biblios, the oldest Mediterranean city. Oh, my God. Unk needs to sit the fuck down. Then let me tell you something. I'm about to be in rare form. I'm about to clown around, right? I know Sarnetta right now is having a live stream. Sarnetta got it going on over there right now, but I just had to share. I said, let me just fucking share and go live in the middle of his life. Sarnetta over there got it cracking. The nigga got 1,300 followers. But don't worry about that shit. You can pause that shit, and you can watch it later on in the night. But focus on me right now. It's between me and you right now. You can go to Sarnetta anytime. Same old shit he been talking for this last 12 years. We talking some go against the grain shit here. Roll with pimping, okay? Pimping got you covered. See, Chief X up in here, I got the Vans on tonight. Got my little Van shirt, right? I'm rocking my Van shoes, you know what I mean? The Van and white. The blue hat to match the blue shoes. I'm fly. I stepped out the house today and went shopping. I was all at Costco's. You know what I mean? I'm catching them from 18 to 80, blind, crippling, crazy. I'm telling you, the little 25-year-old chicks was on me tonight. I'm trying to tell you what's real, right? From 25 to 60 years old, I'm popping them. You understand me? Mothers and grandmamas. I'm a grandmother fucker. Hey, check this out. Pseudo Killers is breaking up. It's chaos. It's bedlam up in here. What you say? Ask me why you laughing at me. 18 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy, right? I'm 53 years old. I knocked a 25-year-old today. I wouldn't give a fuck. Shit. I'm still handsome. You know what I mean? My chest is still popping up out there. I get grandmamas and mamas. Wait a minute. That whiskey talking tonight, I'm in a good mood. What you say, Armchair? Watching Chef and Corey confronting Ankh was like watching a rerun show. Excuse me. A rerun of the show Intervention, where they confront drug addicts. Hey fam, Pseudo Killers was lit tonight. They was arguing. Sheffrin and Corey came on out. They said, we kicking Ankh out the Pseudo Killers. Ankh kicking and screaming, I'm not going nowhere. I'm not going nowhere. I will burn the whole house down before I let y'all kick me out. Y'all won't get your information out. I'll kill it all, Ankh said. Fuck you, niggas. I don't care if I got my own channel. My ass is selfish. You know what I mean? Fuck you, niggas. You won't get Chief X on this motherfucker channel if I can help it. That's all Ankh was saying. Trust and believe, Ankh, for 2 whole years, have been arguing against Chief X. You niggas think he's acting pseudo and acting weird and acting crazy? Nah. Brother Ankh is a science guy. He knows what time it is. He's just going berserk. So Chief X can't win. So Chief X don't sound right. Ankh is spiting himself. No. I said that wrong. Ankh is being disingenuous as hell to spite Chief X. Y'all think he believed that bullshit he preaching and talking a bunch of bullshit. Nope. He is so dead set on not letting Chief X seem like he's right. He will lie, cheat, and steal. Go all out his way to argue silly shit. You can say 1 + 1 = 2. And he'll say, hell no, it don't equal 2. Just because Chief X think it equals 2. Listen here. It's a, what you say, Chris Eric Christopher celebration. Pseudo Killers kick the biggest pseudo out. Finally shows credibility is back. Now look here. If Eric Christopher is saying credibility is back, that means it's been some incredible shit going on, right? That means it's some pseudo shit been going on, right? That means it's some falsehoods being pushed just to spite Chief X. Let me tell you something, family, you got to understand this. Don't nobody listen to me. What they say, Khalid Shakur? Nope, because a nigga didn't leave me alone, right? Now, Khalid Shakur, I can see if I read in the chat where you told Ankh to leave Chief X alone, but you didn't do that. You know what I mean? So I can't leave Ankh alone. Right? Nah, hell nah. Nope. Check this out. I forgot what my point I was making. My homie Khalid threw me off, right? Let me breathe and calm down. Let me just start off and say this. While I got y'all's attention, because in about 5-10 minutes, a bunch of niggas are going to click off because they don't have the intellectual stamina, right? So let me just say this. Real pseudo hunters who's been 100% in the coalition should move forward. I haven't had no conversation with Sheffrin and Corey about this. But this is how I've been feeling, right? I think Honest Cats should vibe and click with Honest Cats. Let the frauds fuck with frauds. Let the scary cats fuck with scary cats. And the coalition should move forward. This ain't written in stone, but let me tell you right now who the coalition is. As far as stand up 100% pseudo hunters who leave no stones unturned and is real about their scholarship and is real about 100% truth being pushed to the black community. Let me name who the coalition is, and I wouldn't give a fuck if anybody say any different or disagree. The coalition moving forward is Chief X, Sheffrine, Corey Antitheus, Double X, Unbiased Sports, Aku Cromante, and Ngozi. And Ngozi, we've cleaned up whatever we got to clean up. We've had our conversations. Fuck all that dumb shit. Let's go. If I offended you, if you feel got a problem with me, let me just say now, I apologize, Ngozi. I just had to get myself some shit off my chest about you, Ngozi. Okay? I totally, honestly felt that you wasn't keeping it 100 and that you was keeping it 80%, which is good in a passing grade, but I felt you wasn't keeping it 100. So I came for you. And if I offended you, hey, I apologize, but I was sincere in all my intent. But I would love for you to join the motherfucking coalition. We're about the people I named just now, and let me rename them. Double X. That's the BG. The baby gangster. I'm the OG. I'm the original gangster. Double X and Unbiased Sports is my BGs. Them the baby gangsters. Okay? They're going to be on my goddamn team. Right? I would love for Sheffrine, Corey Antitheus, Concrete Corey, whatever you want to call him, Ngozi, Unbiased Sports. Hey, look here. Gullah Geechee, come on home, bro. You be on that shit, but we're going to fix this shit. And me, you, and Ngozi, Sheffrine, Corey, Unbiased Sports, Aku Cromante, we're going to run this shit. It's us against everyone, and that's the way it should have been all the goddamn time. I'm telling you, fuck what these niggas talking about. The cream will rise to the top. It's us against the conscious community, and we're the only realest ones out here. Ankh ain't never been real. Ankh selling Abju wear, and he has to do that, and he has to hold on to Abydos in Egypt because he's still Hotep hustling a bit. Right? I told you niggas a long time ago. And, you know, throughout this spiel, pseudo-killers, Corey and Sheffrine, may get mad at me. They may not get mad at me. But I got to let you niggas know I told you so. Right? But I love you. But I got to scold you niggas too, if possible, in this stream. So look here. I'm telling you with God love. I'm telling you on everything. I know Ankh better than all you cats listening to me or whoever you think you down with him. Or I know Ankh better than all you niggas. I've been fucking with Ankh since the Blog Talk Radio days. I know his every move, what he will say, what he won't say. I know his feelings. I know Ankh in and out. Right? I used to trust Ankh, but over the last 2 years, I seen Ankh has been full of shit. I seen Ankh lie habitually, intentionally, and on purpose over the last 2 years. I've lost respect for the bitch nigga. The nigga called me bitch nigga 100 times. Every goddamn stream, he called me bitch ass nigga. You know what I mean? I have no more respect for the nigga. Me and Ankh tried to make amends about a month ago on the phone. With a mediator, right? I'm sitting here and apologizing, trying to make amends and shit for shit I never did do, right? I'm just apologizing to get the fucking shit over with and be the bigger man. I say, fuck it. But Ankh say, fuck it. I'm apologizing 5 goddamn times, and here it is, Ankh's time to apologize, and what he do? Cuss my mother out, call my mother a bitch, call my mother a whore, and all kind of shit, and went in on me. And I still ain't disrespected his family members or his mama. And I won't do that because I'm not as childish as this bitch nigga is, okay? I'm focused on his ass, right? So if I'm insulting somebody, if I'm coming for somebody, I'm coming for him, not his family members. Rest in peace to his beautiful mother. That's what I will say. He can cuss my mama out. He don't know my mama. He can do all this wicked and foul shit. Niggas can side with him if they want to. But I know I'm the righteous one in the end. I know in the end, Chief X has great intentions. He means no harm to nobody. Chief X don't owe a penny to anyone. Anybody who does business with Chief X get their products, and they get their products on time. Can't say so for Ankh or the rest of these bitch-ass niggas in the conscious community, okay? Okay? I see your armchair, right? So, I've been righteous. I've told people why me and Ankh fell out. And people just didn't give a fuck. I'm telling you what's up with the conscious community. The conscious community is into personalities over principles. They don't give a fuck about principles. They give a fuck about personalities. And they will kowtow to or suck up to personalities over principles and truth, right? Let me tell you something, and I've been saying this for the longest, and this is the problem. This is why I had to free myself, and I always said I'm the Long Ranger. Ankh, Brother Any Headrit, would talk that shit like Chief X wanted to join these organizations and Chief X wanted to be down, but we... Nigga, I've always said I was a Long Ranger. And let me be honest. The only organization I thought about joining and being cool with at one time was NBK. But fuck them niggas too. Because I seen they were some fake ass niggas. This nigga True Story won't even show his motherfucking face. Okay? They may give some good information. But I seen Rob Bourne was a fucking emotional wreck. Right? I seen Rob Bourne was full of shit. And he was into personalities over principles too. Although these niggas may kick some real shit, they have some other issues going on, right? When a nigga won't show his face, I don't know about a nigga like that. Just a coward-ass nigga to me. We grown-ass men. I'm not scared to show my face. I have confidence. What the fuck am I scared to show my face for? So True Storian ain't show his face. So, but, and that's a whole nother story. Ankh don't even understand evolution well. He, no, you know, let me stop. Ankh understands evolution, but he ghostwritten that book. He didn't write his evolution book. That shit was ghostwritten. Tell the truth, Ankh. Get honest about that shit. So check this out, family. Pseudo killers supposedly have broken up. Not really. The channel will still be up. And these cats will think about it and make amends and get back together. I'm just trying to tell you how it is, right? Brother Ankh has always been a bully. This is nothing new. It's his way or the highway. I've watched Brother Ankh since the Blog Talk days, vibe with certain cliques, and then dismiss certain cliques. Vibe with different cliques, and then dismiss certain cliques. He'll have all these mentally disturbed people on his team and on his side, and then 5-6 months later, they not there no more, and he doing some other shit, fucking with some other people. You know what I mean? Amon Ra Squad broke up because Ankh is a punk-ass leader. He's a horrible leader. Pseudo Killers is breaking up because Ankh has been a bad leader. He's a horrible leader, right? Now, understand this. I say this over and over and over, and people don't get it. This is what you got to understand. There ain't but a few channels out here that people can be seen and heard on. If you're not on these few five channels, you're not going to be seen or heard. I understood the assignment long ago. I have my own channel right here, Chief X, where I can express myself, talk my motherfucking shit, get some motherfucking views, and do my thing, get my message out, get some truth out, do what the fuck I want to do on my fucking channel. And I built my shit years ago. Because these funky ass niggas ain't about shit. Right? So, you only have a few channels out here where certain people can be heard or seen on. Let me name them. Sonnetter as the godfather of this social media, YouTube, getting the message out shit. Sonnetter, let's be real. Garfield. Amon Ra Squad and its affiliates. Although there is no Amon Ra Squad anymore, there's only Brother Ankh and Smash Rockwell. Amon Ra Squad has disintegrated. I broke their ass up. So, since you only have several channels that people can come on and be heard or seen, that means people are not going to be genuine. Because they're going to do whatever they need to do to suck up to the channel host so they can continue to be heard or seen. Whether they're behaving foul or not, they are forced to behave foul or not to continue to be heard or seen. You can know in your heart and soul and for a surety that Garfield Reed of the Dagger Squad is a scam artist, which I proved without a shadow of a doubt. But since you can't be heard or seen anywhere else, you'll cater to Garfield, you'll suck up to Garfield, and you'll act like he's not a fraud and a scammer, so you can be heard or seen on his channel because you don't have any other options and you don't have a channel yourself to be heard or seen. So what you do, and what I've always told you niggas do, you will sell out so you can be heard and seen on Garfield's channel. Now, this probably be the only part that Chefron and Corey may get mad at me about. But I love you, brothers, but I got to say this. Ankh is a known figure in the so-called conscious community. He is a person or a channel to suck up to so you can be heard or seen on YouTube. Without Ankh, a lot of people can't be heard or seen on YouTube. So people will sell out and side with Ankh, although Ankh is wrong and evil as fuck, so they can be heard or seen. Now, pseudo killers, the only two realest ones on the pseudo killers is Chefron and Corey. That's it. Chefron and Corey likes a few other people on the pseudo killers. But let me be honest about them. You can believe me or not. There's no real pseudo killers except Corey and Chefron. Brendan is not real with his shit. Brendan only gets real when he's forced to get real because others are getting real in his presence. Outside of that, Brendan is not going to keep it real. He never ever has. He's only kept it real because he was forced into keeping it real by Corey and Sheffrey. Outside of that, he has always sided with Ankh. And Brendan tries his best not to get on Ankh's bad side because he's a little weak like that. He has intellectual abilities. I'm not taking that from him. But Brendan is soft and weak when it comes to Ankh. He doesn't really want to let Ankh know the real and say, Ankh, you're wrong about this. Corey and Sheffrin's right. I agree with Corey and Sheffrin, Ankh. You're wrong on this one. He can't do that. It's not in him to do that. Because he has to suck up to Ankh to be heard and seen. Brendan does not want to fall out with Ankh. Because if Brendan falls out with Ankh, he can't be heard or seen nowhere on YouTube. So Brendan kowtows a bit and is not 100 on point and honest. Kent is way worse. I don't know how Kent can even be. I don't even know how you guys let Kent on the team. Kent has never, ever brought anything intellectual to the table. Kent is strictly 100% a yes man for Brother Ankh. Clint is intellectually stagnant and full of shit. To call him a pseudo-killer is disrespectful. It's disrespectful at this point. It's always been disrespectful. I don't know what the fuck. See, at a point when serial killers jumped off, they just wanted to have a family, and they just included anybody who wanted to be down. Fuck it. They didn't have no checks and balances. Anybody who wanted to be down, fuck it. Come on. That was one mistake. Kent isn't a pseudo killer. Kent is pseudo. Cedric Ortega is not a pseudo killer. It's not his nature. Cedric Ortega is fake. Cedric Ortega has been lying for years on the Pseudo Killers channel, claiming he has a degree in biochemistry. Cedric Ortega is a habitual liar. Let's be real about that. Cedric has no motherfucking degree. And that's why he can't get this $100 I have to offer his ass if he can prove that he has a bachelor's degree in biochemistry. Cedric Ortega is full of shit, and he's another motherfucker who's a Ankh yes man. He's never been a pseudo killer. The only time these men have gotten honest is when they were forced to. Because the entire group got honest. So, hey, they figure they get honest too. But if you guys niggas didn't, they'd be the same niggas who's claiming the Egyptians is black, the Moors is black. They'd be the same niggas who's talking that dumb shit. I don't know how y'all let anybody become a pseudo killer. None of them was real. You have pseudos inside the pseudo killers group, which is crazy. It's like Amun-Ra Squad. Amun-Ra Squad had pseudos all in the mix of the Amun-Ra Squad. How can you guys be pseudo hunters or pseudo killers when you're filled with pseudo motherfuckers? When you're filled with liars? When you're filled with a bunch of fakeness? Let me tell you who's not fake and who's going to keep it real and keep it 100. That's Aku. That's Double X. That's Unbiased Sports. That's Chief X. That's Corey. That's Sheffrin. And that should be the team. excuse me, and Ngozi. And that should be the team. It should be us against everyone. I hit Sheffrain up the other day, and hey, if you want to have a, what were they calling it? I want to say a lesion. Not a lesion. the coalition. That's the coalition. Now, Brother Ankh has his own channel called Real Black Atheist. That's his lane. I've been saying forever, Ankh needs to do his own thing in his own lane. Build his own motherfucking channel up. But we told you niggas years ago that Ankh doesn't do good by himself. He needs a team of people to help him make his points. He's not sufficient on his own like I am on my own and can stand on my own shit. Ankh has never been that kind of nigga. He always had needed a team of frauds to back him. What you say, Donnie Williams? Cedric telling the truth. He got a Mexican green. No pun on the Mexican. Oh, APEP. We're not racist. APEP should be a coalition member. And these niggas, let me just, because these niggas been talking that shit on Pseudo Killers tonight. But ain't really keeping it real. Just about all the moderators on Pseudo Killers is full of shit and weak. You guys can get mad at me if you want to. I'm not your motherfucking role model. I'm not no spiritual cat. I don't hold to no motherfucking conscious community rules. I might talk crazy. I'm half ganja, half man, half, you know, hood, half professional. Kiss my motherfucking ass. All them moderating bitches is full of shit. They the one keep the shit going and help co-sign bullshit. All them moderating bitches and the Pseudo Killers. Fuck them all. They all fake and they all full of shit. They've never been 100. None of them. The only realest one, and she's sometimes fucking shady as fuck, but the realest female moderator is Anusha. And I don't even give her 100% credit. But she's realer than the other ones. Juju, full of shit. Fucking liar. Piece of shit trash. Tell her I said it. I wouldn't give a fuck. CK, a racist bitch. A racist feminist bitch. It's nothing pseudo killer about CK. CK is pseudo as fuck. And a goddamn feminist. I don't even know how she's even down. Because she helps out. And does fucking chat shit. She fucking takes together the fucking, puts together the server and shit. You need her for secretary duties and shit. Crazy bitch. Kiss my ass, motherfuckers. I wouldn't give a fuck about none of you niggas. CK's a bitch. And an angry bitch. And an unhappy with life motherfucker. She's unhappy the way she looks. That's why she has never, ever shown her face on a panel in 2 motherfucking years. She's never put a video and showed her face and her talking in 2 years. That's fake shit. Carter C. Goodson, you right about that. Brother Thunder is a real pseudo killer. Brother Thunder should join the coalition. Thunder may not know his shit, but at least Thunder is honest and wants to get to the bottom of it. You niggas donating to Juju for this cancer she claims she's had, and maybe she do got cancer. But a donation ain't gonna solve no goddamn cancer. I brought Juju into this intellectual scholarship community from the RBG community. And she turned on me. Fuck that bitch. Niggas over here capping for Tiffany today. Tiffany ain't all the way 100. I've seen Tiffany come for APEP. And Tiffany supposed to be a moderator. Tiffany ain't never done her job of moderating. Niggas can insult guests. Niggas can be foul in the chat. Tiffany ain't checking the motherfucking thing. She'll let shit go wild. Tiffany see on a daily basis people being rabid racist to APEP all chat long for a whole year. APEP snapped back one time after 150 insults. He snapped back one time, and you niggas got the audacity to try to put him on blast. You fake-ass motherfucking liars. You fake-ass niggas. All you wrench-carrying motherfuckers and pseudo-killers is fake as fuck. I'm on a motherfucking rant. Haskell, Peter Bagjuice, talk shit about me all goddamn night. Calling me a thief, 2,000 niggas listening to him. Corey, I know you cool with Haskell, but Haskell's a bitch-ass nigga who's a fraud and a habitual liar and who has no integrity. Fuck Haskell. He's disrespectful as hell. Who you say AWOL Mac gives Butch vibes? You may be talking about CK. I don't know which one you're talking about because I ain't been following the chats. But God damn it, I've told people. CK is half a Butch. CK is in the closet like a motherfucker. CK needs to come out the closet and say, you know what, I'm a gay woman. Fronting with this nerdy ass nigga that's in my pictures on Facebook. But really, I like women. That's why I'm a feminist. And fuck you niggas. That's CK's stance. How the fuck is she a pseudo killer? I'm coming for everybody, goddammit. People can be mad at me, but goddammit, I gotta get this shit off my chest. he said her and Tiffany French. Now, Tiffany French is another crazy bitch. Nigga, fuck y'all. I'm not into none of that bullshit. Shit. I'm not that well. I am not your role model. I am not the conscious community role model. I'm a cat born in Compton. Nigga, I don't give a fuck about none of that dumb shit y'all talking about. Tiffany French is crazy as a motherfucker. None of these heifers got a job. These niggas can stream for hours and hours all day. What up, my nigga? Ha ha ha! ain't finished. I'm about to. Let me get back to it. All right. Like I said, I'm on fire. Somebody say, oh, shit, don't do it. I've been giving Dr. Maya a pass because I like Dr. Maya. But Dr. Maya, let's be honest. Dr. Maya has said, fuck Amon-Ra Squad. I'm fucking with all the pseudos. I'm sucking up to Tariq Nasheed because Tariq Nasheed give views. I don't give a fuck if Tariq Nasheed is a fraud. I'm sucking up to him. Niggas done sold out. Right? Dr. Maiat said, fuck that shit. Now, Dr. Maiat is a real scholar. She's actually literally has a PhD. She is a wise woman doing good work teaching at the university. That other shit she doing with the conscious community boggles me. Dr. Maiat used to be down with ADOS, ADOS. I don't know how she's all of a sudden supporting FBA and fake-ass Tariq, who stole ADOS intellectual property in frontin'. I can't stand FBA niggas. I'm with the originals and the credentialed people called ADOS, who has a real, full-blown lawyer and a full-blown lady with a degree in political science who worked on Capitol Hill. I fuck with the professionals and the experts. Fuck Tariq Nasheed and FBA. That's some fuck shit you niggas is on. If anybody's saying FBA and not saying ADOS, they on some fuck shit and seeking attention. Dr. Maiat is over there fucking with Wesley Muhammad and Tariq Nasheed and all these motherfucking pseudos and these elders pushing Black Egypt and doing all. Look here. Everybody say they got kids, don't have kids biologically. People have adopted kids but ain't being real about it. And don't have biological kids. Because they may not even like men, but I'm gonna move on. Would you say Tariq Bey going in on Tariq Nasheed? Yeah. But even Tariq Bey's a fucking fraud. Just frauds checking other frauds. Yep, Dr. Maiat does have an actual PhD. But a PhD shouldn't be hooking up with Tariq Nasheed. A PhD should have been hooking up with ADOS. But Tariq Nasheed got more followers. So people in the conscious community go for personalities over principles all the time. Trust me. Back to pseudo killers. I'm going to be honest and say this again. With everything I love, and I'm being real as can be, after surveying niggas, and I'm just going to tell you who the realest niggas is. Regarding this history and science shit, Aku Cromante, Double X, Unbiased Sports, Corey, Sheffrine, of course Chief X, and we're gonna throw in Ngozi. That's the motherfucking coalition team right there. That's the untouchable team right there. That's the team that can turn this entire conscious community upside down. Because no one can fuck with us when we on our game. And sincere. There's no scholarship. There's no science that can overturn the shit we push. You can't lose, is what I'm saying. Ah, the homie Arc-X Architect up in here. That's the BG. I'm the OG. That's the BG. Let's keep that shit real. I'm a grandpa. Aku up in here. Hey, bro, it's a turnover. I'm trying to tell you what's real. Pseudo Killers broke up tonight because Ankh refused to keep it real. Ankh refused to get on the right side of history. So, like I'm saying, you have 4, 3, 4, 5 channels possibly that people can be heard or seen in the so-called conscious community. Sonnetta. Brother Garfield, Dagger Squad. Anything Anka's affiliated with. Chief X. Amon Ra Squad affiliates. Other than that, you're talking about some Hebrew Israelites channels. Or some Moorish Brothers channels. Other than that, you're going to be obsolete. Either you fall in line or get ran over. I accept your apologies, A. Womack. I accept your apologies, sister. It's a bunch of people need to be apologizing. Peace to you, Exec Architect. Let me tell you what's happening. Let me just tell you real. If you want to know why these fake-ass niggas hate on Chief X, it's because Chief X has been a pseudo-hunter on an extreme level for a long time. Not per se on YouTube, on Facebook. All these elders, all these people, we get down on Facebook. Not fucking Instagram. On Facebook. And I've been exposing all these frauds in the conscious community for years. Way before I made Black Egypt Debunked. I was the first to expose Umar Johnson. This is at a time where 99% of the community was in love with Umar. I seen through his bitch ass when you guys didn't. Now, in 2022, everyone agrees with me about Umar. But 8 years ago when I was getting on his ass, you niggas was hating on me and thought I was hating. Umar Johnson started collecting donations in the year 2010. Understand what I'm saying. In 2014, I came for him because I spoke to the realtor who was selling that property. Was it St. Paul College in Virginia? I may have the name wrong, but that was the initial property that he made that YouTube video on. And I called the realtor to have a conversation with him because I'm an ex-former realtor. And once I had a conversation with him and I seen he didn't give a good faith estimate on the property, I said, this nigga is scamming and full of shit. And I set forth to tell everybody, Umar Johnson is full of shit. Do not believe him. Niggas was clowning me everywhere. I made a video. This shit was going viral about Umar 8 years ago. And my homie said, Chief X, take the video down. Please take the video down. The video will probably have about 5 million views today if I didn't take it down on Facebook. It reached about 100,000 and I cut the motherfucking video off in 8 hours. Now everybody agrees with me that Umar Johnson's a fraud. So why people don't like Chief X is because Chief X came for all their heroes and sheroes and proved without a shadow of a doubt they're all fraud. I came for Umar first. I came for Sebi. And to this day, I've offered $1,000 for anybody to show proof that Dr. Sebi cured just one person in 30 years of any major disease. Here we are years later, and as nobody can prove it yet. Sebi was a fraud and a charlatan on an extreme level. Niggas hated me for Umar Johnson, for Sebi. I came for Dr. Ali Muhammad, Blue and Red Pill, KT the Arts Degree, Sonnetter, Layla Africa, Dr. Phil Valentine, Bobby Hemet, Infodishi, and I showed them all to be fraudulent liars and frauds years ago. And them niggas have never gotten over it. Although today, they know I'm right. Although today, half the community now all of a sudden is agreeing with me that Egypt is neither black or white. I flipped you niggas over years. This is why a lot of niggas don't like me. They can't be honest and say, you know what? I used to look up to Blue and Red Pill when Chief X was coming for the ass. But you know what? Chief X was right. They were frauds. They can't admit that today. Oh, Brother Polite. I was Polite's biggest critic. I'm Shaka Amos' biggest critic. Shaka Amos is clearly telling you niggas that he was in a relationship with a woman and then he started dating and fucking her daughter. Her daughter clearly told you whole ass niggas that Shaka Amos was fucking her when she was 14 and 15 years old and is a goddamn rapist. Excuse me. Molester. Oh, she made it plain in her 3 hours. And here you niggas is on Sonnetter TV over the last week, Kikin, and Brother Ankh says he cannot be on a panel where Chief X is on the panel. Oh, no way. I can be on a panel with that righteous good nigga. But I can be on the panel with a rapist pedophile, Shaka Amos. You see how sick these niggas is? You see how sick the community is? You niggas can kiki. And what's this nigga named Harris? This former Hebrew nigga that been calling me out wanted to debate. Harris. Whoever the fuck this bitch ass nigga name is, he's over on Sonnetter TV, and you niggas is all lightfooting. Lightfoot act. I like lightfooting around Shaka Amos. You tiptoeing around Shaka Amos. But when I'm on the motherfucker scene, y'all coming hard for my head. But you won't say a motherfucking word to Shaka Amos, who clearly told you he was fucking his woman's daughter. She clearly told you he was fucking her as a minor. She also told you ignorant ass niggas that not only was Shaka Amos getting at her as a minor and her girlfriend who's a minor, he also paid for three of them, her, her girlfriend, and their homeboy, a boy who's a minor. And Shaka Amos was trying to get at the little boy and fuck the little boy, you stupid sick bastards. And here Aki is on a panel with a nigga, kikiing and lightfooting with him. You niggas is fake as hell. You, Chris, MVP Harris. Oh, they all over there tiptoeing with Shaka Amos over on Sonetta Channel. Tiptoeing. Oh, Shaka. Oh, yeah. And this nigga's a full-blown pedophile. But you got the audacity to be mad at Chief X, who ain't done nobody wrong, no or a penny? Nigga, fuck all you niggas. I wouldn't give a fuck. Okay? You niggas know you all heard this woman telling her story about how Shaka Amos was hanging outside of her motherfucking bedroom door when he was with her mama and peeping in there and holding his motherfucking penis while he's fucking stalking and looking all in her room as she's a minor. You heard her say that. Don't play dumb. Ankh. So you can be on a pedophile with Shaka Amos, the pedophile, but not Chief X, the righteous one. Oh, and you the same niggas who called this rapist pedophile Polite the goat, and Polite's your boy. Birds of a feather flock together. All you niggas is sick. If Polite got off on all his charges, Brother Ankh, Garfield, and all these whole-ass niggas can't wait to put that nigga on their goddamn live stream and talk to him and rub shoulders and laugh and cuddle and hug, because these niggas is rapists and pedophile apologists. Let's just keep this shit motherfucking real. I clearly showed you niggas Garfield placing bets that Polite's gonna get off. They praying that this pedophile get off. They know this nigga's a fraudulent scammer. They know all the above, but Polite's the goat? The nigga who said 5G caused coronavirus is the goat in Garfield's eyes? He's Polite's boy? Excuse me. He's Ankh's boy? But he can't even be on a panel with Chief X? If you niggas can't see the light, that's on you niggas. Fuck all you niggas. Only reason I went on Sonetta's TV and I told Sonetta this, and I'll go on there again. I told everybody, Chief X, you said you'll never go on Sonnetta's again. I went on Sonnetta to wage war against him and his beliefs in the entire conscious community. I went on Sonnetta's channel to debunk Black Egypt. I didn't go in there to kiki. I didn't go in there to get along and be a part of the go along, get along game. Chief X came on there for fucking war to put you niggas in a casket. I had bigger fish to fry. I didn't give a fuck about Sonetta per se, but me and Sonetta's in a good space. I'm not dissing Sonetta. What's up, Sonetta? When you gonna let me do that presentation? You ain't checked with me yet, right? Check this out. I see right now I got 50 people listening to me. I just had maybe 25 people listening to me 20 minutes ago. Anybody just coming onto the stream, rewind this motherfucker back to the beginning. Please do that. You didn't miss the whole goddamn show. Fuck this chat. You tell me that I'm lying, that Brother Ankh, Chris Harris, Chris MVP Harris, and these fake-ass niggas who be on my head hard was not fucking kikiing with Shaka Amos, the rapist, just 2 days ago. Tell me I'm fucking lying. Ask these niggas why would they go on a panel with Shaka Amos, a full-blown pedophile, but won't go on a panel with Chief X. Ask them that. Ask these niggas why you come for Chief X so hard, but you ain't had a lick. You ain't bucked up at Shaka Amos a bit ever. Why? Niggas is about personalities over principles. Listen to what I'm telling you. They'll choose Tyreek over Adios S because Tyreek has a bigger following and he can give more attention. You niggas is fake. Now, everybody call Chris Harris out on this. Thank you, armchair philosopher. I forgot. I clearly listened, and he did say he has a master's degree in engineering. Chris Harris don't even have a bachelor's degree. Call that nigga on it, and if you niggas don't call him on it, and if he don't prove he got a master's degree, you niggas is fake and he's fake. Period. These niggas, right. Ankh said Malcolm X was a snitch for saving black people from being exploited by Malcolm from Elijah Muhammad. Nope, I keep telling these hoe-ass niggas. These niggas will slander Malcolm X, but get mad at me because I called Dr. Ben out. I'm listening to Sonnetta say Malcolm X was gay one time. And you niggas got the audacity to trip on Chief X saying Dr. Ben's a liar? Fuck you, you fake-ass niggas. Listen here. These niggas all have came for Malcolm X, and they all came for Farrakhan. You trying to tell me Dr. Ben was bigger than Farrakhan and Malcolm X? Get the fuck out of here. My parents, my entire family, because I've asked them, have never heard of no goddamn Dr. Ben. My brothers and sisters have never heard of no Dr. Ben. My mama and daddy have never, ever heard of no goddamn Dr. Ben. They have all heard of Farrakhan and Malcolm X, though. I guarantee you that. All my family know for certainty who Malcolm X and Farrakhan is. Who the fuck is Dr. Ben? Well, he deserves more respect than Farrakhan and Malcolm X. You niggas is crazy. They've never heard of Sheikh Anta Diop. Or none of them lying-ass Afrocentrics. But they've heard of Malcolm X. They've heard of Martin Luther King. Hey, baby.
Guess what's on tonight?
What's on tonight, sugar?
Yellow.
Oh, shit. Yellowstone is back on. You was 100% right, baby.
Yes.
I'm doing a live and they can hear you, sugar. Bye, baby. What you say, Chris Connors? I'm just gonna form a new group of groupies to hide behind. Listen here, here. Listen, family. Listen, fam. You niggas can get food if you want to. See, this is here's the thing. Ankh is a known commodity in the conscious community. Whether he wrong or right, he's known. So niggas have catered and kissed Ankh's ass because he's known. And that was the only way they can be heard or seen. But it's okay. I got you. Listen, if you listen to what I'm saying, this channel, or if you start a new channel, but really, Ankh, if he's a decent human being, Ankh should let go of the pseudo killers channel. Let them brothers Ankh and Corey do their thing on the pseudo killers channel. And he should go on to his channel, Real Black Atheist. If he was a real and righteous man and had good integrity and meant well. But since he doesn't mean well, he has an ulterior motive and he's in his emotions and feelings, he would rather tear the whole channel down rather than let them brothers do their own thing and let them brothers be free. He would rather tear it all down. That's how much of a hoe-ass nigga he is. And that's why I got hoe-ass Ankh in the title. Ankh has never been a keeper crew. And I've told you niggas that. Ankh is over-demanding. He's a bully. Everything is his way or no way. And Chief X was never the type of nigga who fall in line with an overkill ass nigga like that. Mm-mm. Chief X is an omega, fucking alpha. You guys talk this alpha beta shit, fuck both of them. I'm an omega, okay? And an omega ain't gonna take no alpha shit. A beta may take an alpha shit, but an omega is a loner, and he ain't gonna take no alpha male shit if the alpha male is wrong. If the alpha male is righteous and doing the right thing, hey, we cool. But if you're not, fuck you, nigga. Yeah. Ankh was good for a while. Before a while, he had good intent. But I'm going to tell you something, what happens in this conscious community. Let me just tell you what fucks people up. Let me just tell you what's real. Everyone is, in a sense, clout chasing or looking to get views and or attention. Okay, so everyone is seeking this right now. I'm not clout chasing, or I would be all on Clubhouse, you know what I mean, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, and all, you know. I do this just to have fun, and it's a hobby for me, right? But we all want views. That's the point of making a YouTube video, so people can listen to you and you can get views, okay? But one thing I won't do, and this is why I made a video a while back saying I'm no longer a YouTuber. I gave it a shot for about 4 months, and I said I'm going to grow my channel, and I'm going to get me 100,000 followers. and I'm gonna grow my channel. And I'm gonna be a YouTuber. And I went and bought a microphone and shit, and a new camera and shit. You see how my camera's kind of clean and clear now? And I said, I'm about to be a YouTuber. But then after 4 months into it, I realized something. That in order to be a successful YouTuber, you have to have a niche. You have to have some type of niche that's your lane and that people are into. Right? I didn't have a niche. I strictly just talk in general about history and or science, which is not like a niche per se. So I had to understand that black folk in general are really not into history. So I would never, ever, ever, ever obtain 100,000 followers. I had to come to this understanding and just keep it real with myself, maybe about 4 months ago. I said, I don't really have a niche. I'm kind of like all over the place and just a generalist. I don't specialize in anything. And I just like to get on here and talk some shit. And, you know, I have a hobby. I like, you know, topics of history and science. But it's not like a niche. It's just some shit I like to engage and talk about. Impossible to grow a big YouTube channel regarding history. Impossible. So this is why, like, Amin Ra Squad channel has never grown. Other channels, none of these channels talking history, they've never grown. Unless you may be somebody like Home Team History who has great graphics and you just teach on one subject and you just make a video and you... I mean, like, but... Other than that, you're not going to grow. So, like, pseudo killers, no matter how interesting a drama field or topic may be, they only still got, at best, 2,000 subscribers. At best, I have 6,400 subscribers. And I've been on YouTube forever. I had to come to the understanding and conclusion. I will never be able to grow my channel unless I have a niche. Therefore, I'm not a YouTuber. Therefore, this shit is just fun and shits and giggles for me. That's all it is. So don't think I'm clout chasing. I'm not trying to. I don't be a divisive for attention. This is literally how I feel and think. This is literally information I've came across and literally how I think now and understand now. And I just share how I think and I understand. That's it. You know what I mean? I'm not no big YouTuber. None of that. Breathe, people. Relax. What she say? Role-playing as a scholar. A lot of these cats are role-playing as a scholar. I tell people off the rip, I am the furthest thing from a scholar. I've never, ever claimed that in my life. A lot of these cats were claiming they were scholars. They act like they don't and backpedal now, but trust me, I got all these niggas on record claiming they're scholars. All of them. Hey, I appreciate you, FSK. Appreciate the super chat. Hey, a lot of North Africans, a lot of Egyptians have begun to follow me. I do have a super chat now. I guess because I've gotten over 1 million views for all these years of all my videos combined. So I don't know if that was a thing, but they allowed me to have a super chat now. So a lot of times people couldn't cash at me because they're out of state. So if you're out of state, you can't cash at somebody in the United States. All right. But if you're out of the country, you can super chat me. I appreciate it. And if you did want to, Donnie Williams, man, I appreciate you, bro. Listen, bro. If you wanted to, throw your brother Cash App for all this goodness I've been teaching. I've been teaching shit that the conscious community do not teach. Totally against the grain. And anyone listening to me right now know for certainty that I've given them food for thought unlike no other. If you're being honest, Chief X has given you food for thought unlike no other. And I have changed the way you think. I have changed your understanding of history. Thank you, Donnie Williams. And all the above. Let's keep that shit real. If anyone deserved a Cash App, it's me. Not Brother Reggie. I heard, since we're talking about the pseudo killers and real pseudo killers and fake pseudo killers, Brother Brendan, bruh, you sat here and came for me one day on my channel claiming I'm over talking one of my guests while Ankh is the biggest over talker ever, and you've never said that to him. So, Brendan, why? What is your fear of Ankh that you just can't keep it 100? And just flat out saying, get some fucking balls, man. Get some fucking confidence and get some fucking balls and say, Ankh, you are wrong for that. When have you ever said, Ankh, you're wrong for that, Brendan? And what is what you in this? I don't know what was wrong with you today on Pseudo Killers. Every time Corey calls you on something, you seem to always want to say something that Ankh may like because you just don't want to totally make Ankh mad. It'd be so obvious that you're trying to remain so cool with Ankh. Because without Ankh, Brendan, nobody would know who you are. And this is why you still sell out a little bit. Although you be real, but it's you're only real because Corey and Chevron forces you to be real. Hey, Scarface, I appreciate you. You say you never miss one. Remember, you make my day. When you honest like that, I appreciate your videos as well. I never miss one. I appreciate the donation. I appreciate all the donations I've had today. Yeah, you know, I'm not totally getting on Brendan the Q. Brendan's a great researcher, but he's just not great on just putting it out there and keeping it fucking strictly real. He has to cater a little bit to the pseudos to not make them feel so bad and leave the door open for Ankh a little bit. And just shut this nigga down and stop it, Brendan. You have that power. See, Ankh said, like, when Chefreen and Corey was saying to you, Brendan, that Ankh listens to you. He respects you. Ankh listens to you and respects you because you've never came for him. You've never been divisive with him. You've always catered to him. So Ankh will listen to you. So what Corey and Chevron was saying, Brendan, is keep it real with this nigga for once. God damn. Yeah, you didn't do this, Brendan. What you say? Hey, Womack, that narrative that we were first at everything had us all fooled. Yeah, I mean, like, we're in this competition to be first. First, we're the first. Chill the fuck out. Niggas gotta be first on every goddamn thing. Can't nobody else be first doing anything except you niggas. You niggas will lie, cheat, and steal to be first. Hey, Maria, I always appreciate you. Brendan did not correct Ankh at all tonight, and Ankh was all kinds of wrong. Brendan, you have to do better, bro. Let me just be for real. And this is not no person. When I look at the pseudo killers, and I just look at people who are just 100, all I can think about is Corey and Sheffrey. Nobody else fits the bill of being 100. What you call it is halfway. What's his name? But he hadn't even been around in a long time. What's his name? What's the other pseudo killer brother's name? I can't even think of this cat's name. I can't think of his name. My point is, Sheffrin and Corey is the only ones 100. Sosa! That's his name. Thank you, Armchair. Sosa! Now, if I was to give a third person any props, it would be Sosa. But Sosa's not all the way. He kind of leans and like, I don't know, like he's a little scared sometimes. Niggas, yeah, put your motherfucking feet down and just stand on some shit, y'all. Now, Kent is full of shit. Kent is so full of shit. I text this nigga on Facebook today in his inbox and cussed his ass out. Kent pissed me off so much today. Kent blocked me on my main Facebook page because last week I was on his ass on Facebook. This bitch ass nigga blocked me like a hoe. So I went to my backup Facebook page and inboxed Kent today. Because he pissed me off so much. I said, Kent, you is fake as fuck. Sosa's good people. Right, that's what I'm saying. He's the third person. But Kent is full of shit. Kent is a motherfucking coward. Kent don't stand on a motherfucking thing. And Kent, in 2 years, has never, ever, ever, ever brought anything intellectual to a panel. On his own merit. Ever. Yeah, I guess they are still learning, Donnie Williams. But this is my point is, I don't know how all these motherfuckers became pseudo killers if they're not really pseudo killers. If you ask Kent right now, are the ancient Egyptians black? He's not going to stand on anything. He's going to say, I don't know. He wants to say yes because he's an Ankh dick rider. But he won't stand on anything either way. Cedric Ortega won't stand on shit either way. Coward ass niggas. Niggas got to learn how to take a stance. We said, okay, don't be wrong and strong. What you say, old Mac? Oh, wait, hey, Womack. The elders in the community swear that Europeans were cave dwellers, solely calling them troglodytes and shit. But wouldn't we being the first to do it, be the first cave dwellers asking for a friend. So, like, I'm probably the only one in the community that has got on niggas for clowning caves. As if it's a bad thing to dwell in a cave. I mean, like, Neanderthal and white folk have nothing really to do with each other technically. Neanderthal predate white folk by a long shot, right? So people clown Neanderthals as if it's a negative thing to have an archaic ancestor. Right? So they say cave dweller and cave beast and these crazy, stupid ass shit. But let me tell you something. It is called intelligence to occupy a cave that is in your geographical area. If I'm standing here and it's a fucking cave right there, I would be ignorant to be sitting out here in the fucking rain when a cave can provide me shelter. Can provide me safety. So how was Black Americans clowning people who were in a cave when it was intelligent to be in a cave? You know what I'm saying? Like it's crazy. The conscious community is this crazy. They never think this deep. Listen, if you look in today's modern time, into cave dwellings, just look at them. Cave habitat, or just Google cave living. And they have these plush ass caves where people just plush them out and they living in them. Or listen, I would rather be in a cave than a mud hut. Listen to what I'm telling you, family. I would rather be chilling in a 3,000 square foot cave rather than a 20 square foot mud hut. Now, so when niggas get to clown and cave beasts, think about what Chief X just said. Think about cave dwelling and think about a mud hut, and which one would you rather be in? Now, to be real, the original cave dwellers and where caves are more prevalent is in Kenya. All you got to do is Google caves in Kenya. Beautiful. Kenya got more caves than most places in whatever y'all thought, you know, was Europe and shit, right? But you guys was on them elders talking that dumb shit and this rabid racist shit about cave beast and cave dwelling, and you guys just got the parrot in that shit and didn't know any better. Everyone who had a cave in their geographical area utilized that cave for some reason, bar none. You would be stupid not to. So when niggas say cave beasts and cave, they're trying to insult, but don't know no better themselves. They just talking. Hey, Carter C. Goodson, I always appreciate you, family. One of my most intelligent commenters. So, Carter G. Goodson, you made a great point. Now, I really want to tell the pseudo killers, if they had listened to me a year and a half ago, I said the team. No, matter of fact, I was talking to Aku personally. Me, Aku, Ngozi, and Unbiased Sports. Because at this time, Corey and Chevron was on some crazy shit. They was in love with Ankh at this time. So they wasn't hearing or understanding me. So it was me, Aku, Unbiased Sports, and Ngozi who was going to hook up as a team. But Ngozi was still on some bullshit. And he was catering to Ankh a little bit. And he didn't get it. I'm trying to tell you, a year and a half ago, if we had built the coalition that I was talking about, who were straight killers, who were real pseudo hunters, bro, listen here. We would have all this shit sold up by now. Niggas would be watching all of our videos and following us way more than others. I tried to tell you. I'm telling you right now. The team to build is Corey, Chevron, Chief X, Ngozi, Unbiased Sports, Aku, and Double X. Period. Unstoppable. Like, so, hey, philosopher, I heard that today. Dumbass Haskell, a.k.a. What's this nigga name besides Haskell? Talking about 300,000. I mean, like, Homo sapiens is only approximately 250,000 years old. Anybody talking some 300,000 years is on some fuck shit. What'd you say, Aku? Cave dwelling was the only way to be saved from the fierce environment. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Shelter, safety, away from bad weather. You know what I mean? Like, bro, it's some plush-ass caves. Google plush caves on Google plush caves. And you can be like, damn, I want to live in a cave. All cultures live caves. What is the point of insulting white folk talking about cave dwellers? It's only stupidity that makes you do that. Peter Bagjuice, that's this nigga name. Now, for some reason, Corey likes Peter Bagjuice. I have no reason. I have no understanding why. Peter Bagjuice is the fucking pseudo as hell. He's disrespectful as hell. He's one of these bad behavior ass niggas. Would you say, FSK, the caves in Greece are beautiful? Probably. What you say, Acadia? Have I been reading my search history? Have you been reading my search history, Chief? No. Acadia, do you have content on your channel? Because you always make intelligent comments. So if you always make intelligent comments, that means you should have intelligent content. So I have not looked to see if you have content. So I'm not sure exactly what you mean by have I been reading my search history, Chief X, but I'll check you out. So look here, I'm telling you, a team going forth into the future, because listen, see, this is people, everybody is about recency bias. And the now and right now, see, nobody is planning for. Like Asian people, they're planning for 200 years from now. Black folk don't think that far in advance, right? So I'm talking about YouTube a year or 2 years from now. I say things like, get on the right side of history. I also say things like, there are a couple of things underway that's being testing as far as genetics. And there's going to be some bombshells dropped over the next year or two regarding ancient Egypt. More discoveries are going to come about ancient Egypt. And I'm telling you, in a year or within years, I'm going to be sitting back and be like, I told you, niggas. Listen to this new discovery. I told you. Next year to that, I told you. 3 years later from now, niggas, a whole bunch of people going to be reflecting and looking back on Chief X and said, God damn, that nigga was right. This nigga was right 4 years ago. This nigga been right. We are just now realizing this. And everybody is going to have Chief X on their mind in the next year, 2 years, 3 years. You better get on the right side of history. I'm on the right side of history. I already know what time it is. The Coalition is the hottest group since NWO on pro wrestling. Okay, you know, Chris says, I be hearing that, so I got to get clarification. So some people, I say archaic humans, like homo means human, basically. So homo Neanderthals, they're humans. Homo habiliganza, homo erectus. Now, homo sapiens is what I call us. Some people say homo sapien. So maybe we need to clear that up. Are we homo sapiens or are we homo sapien? Maria say Jebel Rod is 310 years ago. Now, is Jebel considered a homo sapien or homo sapien sapien, or was he the in-between phase, in between the evolution phase? I'm not exactly sure, but it's a whole lot of information poking holes in the 200,000-year-old theory of Homo sapiens. So we may eventually have to extend out to 350,000 years. I don't know. Oh, just a joke. Okay, I got you, Acadia. Okay. You know what? Let me just do this. So since we spoke on it. Hold on. Hold on, people. Let me do this real quick. So, let me just share my screen. Okay, let me just give you an example. I didn't do much. But let me show. Okay, now, this is in cave. It's decorated. They didn't turn out this cave. So, would you rather live in here? Or would you rather live in a mud hut? while you're joking and clowning around. The joke is on you. Now, let me just find some others real quick. Hold on. 1 second. One second, I just gotta show you this one thing. Uh-oh. Okay. Okay, so let me just show you this real quick. Now, Johnny Depp owns a cave that he has decorated, right? How can I blow this up? Hold on. I can't even blow this up to make you see. But if you can see, the bottom right is a cave that he has decorated and he kicks it in. I'm not exactly sure where his cave is. But all I'm saying is caves can be safe. Look at the bottom right. You can decorate them. And it's good living, actually, if you can get some circulation in there, right? And it's larger in some instances than a mud hut, you know what I mean? A teepee and shit, you know what I mean? Native Americans live in a teepee. Imagine living in a plush cave, right? So when niggas get to talking about caveman and cave dwelling and clowning like it's some bad things, think of Chief X and say, stop that capping. It's just a man cave. Look here. I'm in my man cave now. Hold on. Look. It's a man cave right here. Look. I'm in my man cave right now. If this was a real cave, it'd be plush as fuck. Would you say, Dr. Banub, you got one in your garage, huh? Man, like, look, this is my little man cave. This is my, actually, it's my living room, but I live alone, so this is my man cave. My spot. They spamming my chat with this bullshit, huh? Let me block that user, whoever it is. Damn, you can't even block these motherfuckers. They got power. I tried to block one. It said an error. Yeah, that is my hobby, I guess. Dispelling myths, debunking bullshit, right? That's my thing. That is my niche. Oh my God, Hey, so I'm not sure what James you're talking about. Let me also say this. There's two James that be around in these circles. One James is Pan-African Designs. Pan-African Designs is a clothing company owned by James, right? Pan-African Designs has Egyptian symbolism on his clothing. So he has to represent and toe the line and hold on to ancient Egypt as long as possible because his livelihood is based off of it. His clothing. That's his business. Pan-African James, if he's not just keeping it real with you guys. I know Pan-African James from way back. From the RBG community. Going to RBG Family Weekend. That's what he was down with. He had beef with the RBG community because they was tripping on logos and Lone Star RBG who had RBG Family Weekend. You know what I mean? They jumped off RBG Family Weekend. And Pan-African James had a problem with Lone Star RBG's logo. They had beef for years. Pan-African James is in a wheelchair, right? He's a gimp. I'm not insulting him. I'm just being honest and telling the truth. Pan-African James, Pan-African Designs, is in a wheelchair. He's a gimp, right? He's an unhappy person, right? He's bitter. He's always been very bitter and angry at the world and everybody else, right? So Pan-African James is holding on as much as possible. Pan-African James, just 3 weeks ago, thought Nigeria was North Africa. To this day, Pan-African Designed, owned by James, will argue you down about Nigeria being North Africa. This is how insane it is. I could never have people on my panel with these kind of mental health issues. I don't sit here and argue and debate with niggas with mental health issues. Chief X don't do that. If I have a debate, I told Sonetta, nigga, bring me your best. Don't bring me these peons and shit. The only peon I debated was Sekou, and it was child abuse. I should be arrested for child abuse, okay? I said the other two debates was Jabari and Polite. Bring me your motherfucking best. You know what I mean? I want to body slam the best. Don't bring me these motherfucking peons, okay? Yeah. Shakir, you may have not known about James, but let me tell you. Okay? Yeah. James is wheelchair bound. He's paralyzed. I think from the waist down. So if you're sensing a lot of anger and a lot of mental health issues from James, that's one of the reasons why. Okay? Now, the other James, who claims to be an ex-Navy pilot, full of shit. Let me tell you, you niggas is acting like this nigga's a former pilot and actually flew some planes and was actually a Navy officer. Let me tell you, motherfuckers, I was in the goddamn Navy, okay? It's nothing about this other James that says officer. I seriously doubt that he has a bachelor's degree. He's never showed you guys a bachelor's degree. He's never showed you any proof or any semblance of proof that he flies planes, let alone used to fly planes for the Navy. I don't believe him, and I'm just telling you what's real. This nigga's a fraud and a fake. You guys are full of frauds and fake on your channel. Tell this nigga James to show proof that he was a Navy fucking pilot. His logic don't even say that. Do you niggas ever listen to this nigga? Do you know what a Navy pilot sounds like? Let me tell you, because I was in the goddamn Navy. To be an officer, you have to have a degree. Other than that, you're what you call an enlisted man. You're just in an enlisted military. You're not an officer. In the Navy, you have officers which requires a bachelor's degree, and you have enlisted men. The highest Navy, as an enlisted man, the highest rank you can be as an enlisted man is called a Master Chief. Okay, you have a seaman, petty officer first, petty officer third class. You can go all the way up to petty officer first class. Then you can become a chief. Then you can become a master chief. I'm sorry. Senior chief. Senior chief is the highest. It's over master chief. Now, when you're in the military, when you have a bachelor's degree in the Navy, then you're considered a naval officer, right? You can be a junior grade lieutenant, a lieutenant, a commander, a lieutenant commander, and stuff. But whatever, to fly planes, you're supposed to be an officer, and you have a degree in an education. James don't have no degree. James was not no motherfucking Navy pilot. James is a fucking liar. I can listen to the nigga's logic and common sense when he's talking, and I'm going to tell you off the rip, this nigga is not intelligent, and this nigga is not an officer. And never was. Your pseudo killers is damn near filled with habitual liars. Cedric Ortega don't have a degree. And that nigga James don't have a bachelor's degree at all. And he was never a naval officer. I doubt. I could be wrong, but that's just my gut feeling. See, yeah, somebody said, wasn't Ankh in the military too? The difference between me and Ankh is, on Facebook, just 2 days ago, we had Veterans Day. I showed the picture of me in my Navy uniform with my naval hat and my entire outfit in boot camp and posted it. And I said, happy Veterans Day. Have you ever seen Ankh in uniform? Any old picture? I'm also honest and say I did 2.5 years and I got kicked out for having a positive urinalysis for marijuana on my piss test. At least Ankh can say, hey, I did a year and got kicked out. But Ankh ain't no fucking veteran. I tell you that. I know a veteran. Ankh's a fucking liar. Tell Ankh to show you a veteran. If he's not a veteran, that means he got his ass kicked out. Would you say, Eric Christopher? Yeah, these niggas up in here acting like James is telling the motherfucking truth. James is a fraud. Ain't no motherfucking Navy officer, pilot with a degree, gonna be fucking around on the goddamn pseudo killers talking about the Egyptians is black. They don't, their logic ain't that horrible. Every naval officer, especially a pilot, has amazing, great logic. James ain't that. Now, Aku, I see your comment. I'm not sure what James you were saying, so I'm distinguishing the James. There's one James to be claimed to be an ex-military and ex-Navy. And then there's Pan-African Designs. He's James also. Both of the Jameses are full of shit. So don't even cater to that bullshit they talking. And help them niggas lie. Wait a minute, Dr. Maya was in the military? Yeah, I mean, see, the Navy and military has its ranks. It has enlisted men, and it has officers. Officer means you have a degree. Enlisted men, you may have a degree, you just didn't apply to be an officer. But enlisted men usually don't have a degree. I'm an enlisted man. I didn't have a degree. Now, only thing I regret, I went to the Navy out of high school. I should have took my ass to West Point and got on the West Point wrestling team and got me a 4-year degree and became an officer. That's what I should have done. That's one of my regrets and shit. But I didn't wrestle my senior year because I got too cool and shit. But I could have had a degree. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I could have had a scholarship to Arizona State University and been on their wrestling team and killed it. But I was fucking with the wrong crowd. What you say, Pida James is full of shit? Yeah, them niggas is full of shit. And these niggas have no clue that these niggas is full of shit. What you say, sir, have you done a video about the fake black Hebrew Israelites? I have, sort of. 2 days ago, I made a video about the real Hebrews and the real Egyptians. And I did a picture show and showed real Hebrews who actually live in Arab lands, right? And who are actually, you know, of the Hebrew faith strictly. Not these fake Hebrew Israelites in America, right? Yeah, so I just wanted to make this video just to be clear. Ankh is not a person that anyone has got along with for a long period of time. Every 2 years or so, whatever clique Ankh is fucking with, he eventually falls out with them. This has happened at least 4 different times. A lot of y'all are new and don't recall, but I'm trying to tell you on everything because I've been following Ankh since Blog Talk days. He replaces niggas and they replaces niggas and replaces niggas and replaces niggas. Because if you don't agree with him, it's his way or no way. Eventually, everyone falls out with Ankh. I'm not even on a teammate of Ankh, and I fell out with. You know what I'm saying? If you're an honest, upstanding, decent human being and you're dealing with Brother Ankh, you're eventually going to fall out with him if you are trying to be righteous. Because Ankh is not that. Ankh has behavior issues. And to be honest, Ankh actually has slight mental health issues. I'm telling you, I'm not just saying this stuff to clown around. I've worked in the mental health field for at least 10 years, right? I've worked in recovery with people with drug problems. I know Ankh and his kind. I used to be a GSR, which is a group service representative for AA and NA meetings, okay? I know Ankh's kind, okay? I've listened to him for a decade or more. I know this nigga. Ankh suffers from slight mental health issues, okay? This is why he's unemployable, okay? This is why he collects disability, okay? Ankh is not... How can I say it? Ankh is sane, but he has these bouts and moments where his mental health issues take over. Now, most people have slight mental health issues, like a lot of us do, more than you really think. But Ankh literally has slight mental health issues that interferes with his life, it interferes with him progressing in life. It's interfered with his ability to parent. It's interfered with his ability to be a good husband. It's interfered with his ability to get along with peers, okay? This is just how Ankh is. I've been telling people this for the longest. But if you've never worked in the field of mental health, you can't recognize it. And you see, we all do. We all got some kind of slight mental health issues. I got some crazy issues, probably. But, you know, sometimes there's a saying. Is sometimes people can see you better than you can see yourself. So this is why a lot of times I tell people, sometimes you might need to take heed to what a close friend or family member is saying about you. A crazy person is the last person to recognize that they're crazy. They're just going to be in denial for a long time. You hear me? People can see you better than you can see yourself a lot of times. So sometimes you need to listen to how people review you. Right? Like, I was in a recovery home two different times. For a drug problem I had in 91 and 92, right? And I got clean and shit. So I'm in Compton at the House of Uhuru. No, I'm sorry. Compton, the recovery home was called Kazi House. It's funny, because Kazi, these are different African names. The other program I went to, an inpatient program, I stayed in each one about 8 months. They call these places jails and institutions. Inpatient drug programs are institutions. They're similar to jails and prisons, okay? So, I've gotten therapy as an inpatient in these programs. So, when we're in these programs, at the time in 91, 92, they should do what we call a tech therapy. They don't want to do a tech therapy no more, right? It's brutal, right? But you get to learn about yourself, and you get some real treatment, in my opinion. So today we have these Club Med, nice, take it easy on you, recovery programs and shit. But back in 91 and 92, when I was in a program, we talking about Los Angeles, the crack epidemic. Three strikes, you're out. All kind of shit, crazy shit was going on. So at this time in drug programs, they had a tech therapy. They'll sit your ass in a center, in a chair, in a center. And the rest of the people in the recovery home will be in a circle outside of you. You in the middle of a circle, and the group is outside of you, and they shooting at your ass. You little punk ass nigga, you always act this way, and you be this. And they shooting at your ass. And everybody gets a turn to tell you about yourself. So can you imagine 15 motherfuckers shooting at your ass and checking your ass about your bullshit and how full of shit you are and how you need to change your motherfucking life and get your shit together? To me, that was some fucking therapy. Motherfuckers telling you about your ass, nigga. Yeah, no, and they don't give a shit. These is hood niggas. So, I was getting that real hardcore therapy at that time. You know what I mean? And it made me take a look at myself and my life and what I was going through. Right? 8 months straight, inpatient. So, from a lot of this time in treatment programs and getting therapy and then becoming a youth counselor after that, sitting through therapy sessions with master's degrees, therapists, marriage and family therapy counselors and families and mothers and fathers and kids and working with kids and having a caseload and all this shit. Mental health is a simple subject, and I can look at a motherfucker, I can listen to a motherfucker and tell, yeah, that motherfucker got slight mental health issues. Ankh is one of those niggas. He has communication problems. All the above. What you say, Dr. Banu? I attended electroshock therapy as a student during a rotation at the San Diego VA. It was disgusting. Now, there's a lot of treatments that were disgusting that we learned over time is not good and good and needs to change and shit. So in 91 and 92, when I was into that attack therapy, when you're in drug programs and shit, a lot of shit's changed now, right? That's a whole nother story. Okay. You know what, Acadia, you are so right. She says, I think every human would benefit from rehabilitation. No addiction needed. Right. You don't even need an addiction or some kind of drug program. Every human would benefit from some kind of therapy or rehabilitation. Learning about yourself and your psychological issues, what you went through when you was a kid. Like a lot of these women, why did you use drugs? Or why did you quit at this point? Why did you continue to use drugs? Why did you continue to destroy your life? There's reasons behind all that. And you find that out when you get into therapy. A lot of people haven't found out what their issues are because they've never been in therapy. They've never been around another group of people and hearing the group of people share their issues, and maybe you can identify with this issue that this person went through. A lot of men don't even know how much molestation and rape that women specifically have went through unless they've been in these treatment programs and therapy and counseling and things like that. It's way beyond what you would ever think. So, a lot of times, I even understand women's issues better than most men because of this treatment and therapy that I've been through. Would you say, cool, if people still go to Ashraf Kwesi lectures there? Yeah. Ashraf Kwesi is from Los Angeles. He moved to Dallas, so he lectures more in Texas now, but he's from L.A. So, I grew up under Ashraf Kwesi in L.A. Ashraf Kwesi. And Steve Coakley was the people who I sat at under religiously. I've heard everything Ashraf Kwesi has said in a lecture. So, and especially this time of year is Ashraf Kwesi's favorite time of the year. Because that's it. That cool? Crash Unity Center. So at this time of the year is Ashraf Kwesi's famous time. It's where he goes around the country and lecture on Christianity and the Christ myth and how it relates to Christmas time. Crash Unity Center in L.A. Yep, that's the spot. The pastor there, it's like a church. It's a cool spot. Mary Cara passed away last year. He had a funeral last year. So I haven't been there in a couple of years though. Now before Crash Unity Center, we used to go to a place on Exposition in Crenshaw in the Conscious Community. This is before there was even a YouTube, before any of this bullshit y'all was into, right? Green Life. Was it Green Life? Green Life health food store on Exposition in Crenshaw. That's where I used to go to and listen to Steve Coakley way back in the day. Even Phil Valentine did a lecture or two there. I mean, like, I'm talking about OG shit. Like, way back in the day shit. I remember Steve Coakley. Before Steve Coakley passed, I took a picture with him at the mall, right? But I knew Steve Coakley. Like, you know, Brother Reggie be talking about how he knew Dr. Van. I knew Steve Coakley, like, better than Reggie knew Dr. Van. Like, so, like, when Steve Coakley got sick, he was in a nursing home here in L.A. Matter of fact, I used to fuck the chick who was his nurse at the nursing home. Funny thing is, the chick who used to be Steve Coakley's nurse at the nursing home before he died, She also used to be a porn star. Funny story. I'm talking too much now. But, yeah, I used to fuck this girl. And she was Steve Coakley's nurse. Steve, because she used to always say Steve Coakley had an attitude. But he did. Steve Coakley was an honorary son of a bitch. Steve Coakley was Mr. Scrooge, like for real. And I remember when I first met Steve Coakley, I didn't know he was so Mr. Scrooge. But I liked him so much, I didn't trip on his attitude. So one day, Steve Coakley finished doing a lecture at Green Life Health Food Store. And he got some donations. And at this time, I'm young. I think it might have been 1994 or whatever it was. I'm probably maybe about 24 or whatever. And I was just impressed by Steve Coakley's lecture. So he got a bunch of donations from the crowd and shit. He's over here in the corner just counting his money and shit. Nigga flipping money. I said, damn, Steve Coakley came up. He flipping. So I walk up on Steve Coakley while he counting money. And the nigga straight checked me. What the fuck is you doing? Like, Steve Coakley is gangster. Fuck is you doing? You see me counting here? Don't be bothering me when I'm counting my money. What's up with you? And Steve Coakley checked me. From then on, I said, I apologize. Excuse me. I didn't mean no harm. You know what I mean? Well, from then on, then he kind of was nice to me afterwards. But from that day on, every time he seen me and we chit-chatted, we was always cool. That's my nigga, Steve Coakley. Don't you say Steve was pseudo but likable? What you say, Uncle? I've been to Lamert Park Drumming Circle. Nothing but crazy people down there. I'm telling you, Lamert Park is what we call Little Africa. But Lamert Park is full of crazy nutcases. They've been in the drum circle playing the drums and patting and shit, and people be dancing, doing their little Africa. Everybody in that African circle dancing crazy as hell. Mental health problems is rampant. You was right about that, Aku. Oh man. What you say, Arcadia? We are a country of daddy issues that turn into everything else. Every woman I met that was very promiscuous was messed with as a child. Right, right. So, you're saying that, like so, this is why I'm so hard on polite in Shaka Amo. I have a background of dealing with women in recovery programs, women in working in mental health, me working at Edelman's Children's Court for 2 years as a legal assistant, reading all them child abuse cases, right? So I have problems with people like Polite and Shaka Amos, deeper than just the average Joe Blows who, you know, and this is why I be on their ass. These niggas is frauds. These niggas is pedophile and sexual predators. Shaka Amos and Polite are sexual predators who will ruin a female's life and not give a fuck. So I have problems with niggas like Ankh and Garfield saying they're the GOAT. See, you gotta think deeper into my psychology. When I know for certain that these niggas are sexual predators, and then you got niggas calling them the GOAT and they boy, oh, that fucks with me. Yeah, you niggas is birds of a feather. I'm telling you, you niggas may not see through shit, but I'm telling you, only birds of a feather would consider polite that. And all these niggas that put a mic in police in polite's face is suspect. I'm telling you what real. I would never have no kids around a nigga like Brother Reggie. Polite. Garfield. Shaka. No nigga who cap for polite or Shaka. Uncle Kick. Never would have any kids around any of these niggas. Any of these niggas that can co-sign pedophiles will do the same goddamn thing because they think it's cool. I had to realize, and I'm going to just tell you, this is just some wisdom and my insight. All these niggas I named and a lot of these niggas out here, they deeply feel in their heart, because they've been listening to a lot of pimp bullshit. They've been listening to a lot of fuckboy bullshit. These niggas actually feel that as long as a girl has a menstrual cycle, she's okay to be fucked. I'm telling you, a lot of men feel this way deep down inside. They won't say it. But all these niggas I named think that way. I'm telling you with God love. They feel as long as a girl had her menstrual cycle, she's ready and fuckable. And if you took the pussy, it's okay. This is why they still kiki with polite and Shaka Amos. And to this day, has never ever denounced either of them brothers. Show me one time where Ankh, Garfield, Brother Reggie, any of these clowns denounced polite or Shaka for any of that foul behavior with little girls. Never once in their entire life. Chief X would do it at the drop of a dime anytime. Fuck them niggas. It's just the difference between a real one and a fake niggas. I'm telling you, Acadia, trust me. Listen to my 52-year-old wisdom. These niggas I named feel in their heart, in their mind, that as long as a woman, a chick, a girl, had a menstrual cycle, she's able to be fucked. I mean, and it's okay. And it's not that big of a deal if you took her off. If so many men think like that, I'm going to be honest. If these niggas ain't denounced polite and Shaka, and today, 2 days ago, you seen these niggas on a stream with Shaka. I'm talking shit about Shaka last week before that. But I would never, even if Shaka said he'll debate me, you will never ever see me on a live stream with Shaka. You will not even see me debating Shaka. Only thing you'll see me doing is clowning this bitch ass nigga. Period. Watch this, hold on. You think I'm playing? Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
People sold drugs, sold some. Mm. Could you, yo, share my screen, please. Come on.
Listen. Trust me, listen. Just listen to Chief X. Hey, moderators, Miss Tiffany, CK, you supposedly feminists, Anusha, listen here, sisters, I got your back. Niggas who you think got your back don't. Watch this.
Share screen. Yo, share my screen, please.
This is Shaka Amos, who admitted that he was fucking his ex-girlfriend's daughter, and his daughter made a 3-hour video about Shaka Amos molesting her from 14 years old till she was 20, till she was in her 20s. Guess who's on a panel with this nigga, Shaka? Kikiing and laughing and not giving this nigga no smoke. Ankh, right here, bottom left. Brother Reggie, top middle. And this bitch-ass nigga, Chris Harris, in the middle. They all light-footing with Shaka. They all know Shaka is guilty of this. They all seen the woman clown Shaka and talk about him for 3 hours that he molested her, that he was fucking her while her mother was asleep. They all seen all that shit. But guess what? Ankh said he refused to get on a panel with the likes of a nigga named Chief X. But he would love to get on a panel with a nigga named Shaka Amos, who's a full-blown pedophile. If Polite came on the scene right now, these niggas would be on the panel with Polite. But not Chief X. Here these niggas is right here. Look.
Come on. Present. Share screen. All right.
Was that it, Reggie?
Yeah, screen sharing, brother.
Told me that, and that's why I say you're really not qualified to have this conversation.
Look at these niggas. They is happy. Ankh right here, bottom, second from the left. Reggie above Ankh. Chris Harris on the bottom right. All on the panel was Shaka Amos, who clearly admitted fucking his girlfriend's daughter and having a relationship with her. They all know he's a pedophile and a rapist. They don't give a fuck. But they will never, ever be on a panel with Chief X. You niggas' minds is gone. Plain and simple. You niggas' minds is gone. You niggas have low morality. You niggas ain't shit. Ankh clearly said he will never be on a panel with a nigga like Chief X. Oh no, Chief X is a bitch ass nigga. But the nigga will run to be on a panel with a motherfucking pedophile. Sick ass niggas. This is the conscious community. Predators. Cacadia, predators, all of them. I'm telling you, them niggas just ain't been caught up. I'm telling you, I know a predator when I see a predator. I know a predator when I hear a predator. I worked at Edelman's Children's Court, a dependency court for kids that's been through child abuse, and I've read 100 files when I was the copy room clerk, and all them DCFS attorneys used to give me the file to copy and bring it to the courthouse. I've read them all. I know these niggas' profiles. Ask these niggas why they haven't denounced Polite or Shaka. None of them. Ask them. Ask these niggas why, when Polite has been found to have 6 semen stains on a 14-year-old girl's clothing, and why these smart niggas who are street smart are acting like they're confused and haven't denounced Polite, and he got 6 fucking semen stains on a little 14-year-old girl's clothing. Ask this nigga why he haven't denounced Polite yet. Oh, Chief X, and oh, well, I'll put a nigga in the dirt. If they ever fuck around, I got 2 daughters. I'm not playing with you niggas. Niggas talking that shit. Come around my shit. Try to put your hands on me. It's some niggas talking that shit. Try to put your hands up. Listen here. I'm 52 years old. I'm not fighting no more. I like to fight and will get down. But when I really think about it, I don't want to be taking no motherfucking blows. Because if you get in a fight, whether you win, you're still going to lose. If I beat this motherfucker's ass and have a cut, a nick, or a fractured wrist, or anything from putting hand, I'm still hurt, injured. I still lost, even though I won. So today I practice self-defense. Oh, matter of fact, I'm sitting here going over my little gun today. Let's do a gun review. I'm a 2A guy. I'm really a 2A guy. I like to do gun reviews. I follow all the gun channels. This is my Smith & Wesson 357. This is not the one on my hip. But I keep this motherfucker. I got it wrapped in some panties. So, let me take these 357s out of here. Spear gold dot, hollow point. These are law enforcement use these quality self-defense ammo. But check this out. I just wanted to do a little review on this gun anyway. This is my Model 19 Performance Center, right? As you see, it's empty. It's empty. But this is my most quality firearm. This is a 357 Magnum, and of course 357 Magnums also shoot 38 specials. Right? This is a quality Smith & Wesson Performance Center. So this is just not like the one of the regular ones. This comes from the Performance Center. Meaning all of his actions is top of the line, right? The trigger is like butter. Especially the single action. That's like butter. This is a work of art. Even the double action is fine, though, too. This trigger is amazing. But this is just a quality 357 new school modern Model 19. This motherfucker is beautiful. So for a long time, I used to want this gun and ask for it, right? So unlike the older models, which have a the I forget what the name of it is. The needlepoint on the hammer. This hammer don't. It's just a hammer. And it's MEM parts. So it just fires and it has a... yeah. This is my baby right here, bro. So, I don't know. A lot of y'all ain't been promoting a lot of the 2A information. The New York Supreme Court case was settled and won. So a lot of the restrictions for conceal and carry have been removed. So for instance, in Los Angeles, I applied for my conceal and carry permit, had my interview and live scan and all that already. And in New York, a lot of people don't even know, but in New York, you can now apply for your conceal and carry permit and get approved. And you don't have to give a reason why. I didn't lost my damn ammunition. Why you want to conceal and carry? Because it's none of their business, says the Constitution, right? So let me put the panties back on my over my gun. So the difference, you know, when you have when Smith and Wesson, right? Smith and Wesson guns will come in a gray case or a blue case. When it comes in the blue case, that's how you know it's just a regular, you know, ammo. But when it comes in a gray case, that's from the Performance Center. So this is a Performance Center 357 Magnum that I keep by my bedside. But this one, I keep on my hip. This is just a smaller 38 special. It's not a 357 Magnum. All right. Let me take the ammo out of it. It's empty. As you see, it's empty. But this is like my best friend. It's a smaller, lightweight. It is aluminum frame with carbon steel cylinder and carbon steel barrel. And this is like 14 ounces. It's lightweight. So it's a perfect gun for conceal and carry, right? And it's just a small five-shot revolver. I don't need all that capacity and shit, you know what I mean? Like, for instance, just say I had a Glock, you know, with 15 rounds in the clip and shit, you know what I mean? Like in court, in a self-defense case, this gun would look good, and it would look better in a self-defense case. This is only a five-shot revolver. It's not like a firearm where I need to be, where I'm in some kind of civil war, and I need 15, I need to be able to shoot 15 bullets and shit like that. Now, this is just for up close and personal. They call it a get-up-off-me gun, strictly for self-defense. If a motherfucker's trying to harm, kill, or maim you, you save your life by putting one in them. Anything other than that, and I'm shooting at people, and somebody's getting away, and I got some, all this clips and the AK, and I'm firing at people, that's a murder case. The only time you win a self-defense case is if somebody was actually trying to harm or kill you and you shot them in order to save your life or save yourself from being maimed and killed. That's self-defense. Other than that, it's murder. So five shots is all that's necessary. This is why I'm just strictly a revolver guy. I got one semi-automatic, and it's a mouse gun that's even smaller than this. And that's just used for planking and just for having fun. He said, "Here, Christopher, black or white, your bullets ain't racist." No, they ain't. Yeah. I'm just live talking shit. I've been gone for 2 hours and 45 minutes. So the conceal and carry, you can't even tell. I'm not even printing, right? You can't even tell. I'm not even printing. So don't try me. Don't try me. What you say? I'm not leaving no motherfucking shells. Well, B. Harrison said, "Nigga, wear that wire." I don't know who he's talking to. This nigga them folk. So niggas ain't used to real ones. They ain't used to real niggas talking about two-way shit, you know what I mean? And firearms and shit, protection, and CCW permits. And see, B. Harrison ain't used to that kind of shit. He's probably a nigga with a felony who can't carry, right? So he's used to niggas with nefarious intent, right? This is why. Black folk was against the white boy. Rittenhouse. Oh, during the riots and shit before Biden election, he shot three motherfuckers who was trying to harm him. Niggas was against this cat because he was practicing self-defense. Niggas was mad that this white kid blasted them motherfuckers and didn't get in trouble. Soon as I seen the videos, since I'm a 2A guy, I said, "Oh, that's clear self-defense. Oh, he's getting off. Good job, kid." And what was he there for? Protect property. What was niggas and everybody else there for? To loot, rob, and steal, and tear up shit. So who was doing the righteous thing? Protecting property, niggas? Or the ones robbing, looting and burning? So, B. Harrison don't understand real shit, right? B. Harrison is a felony kind of nigga, so he can't carry, right? So, B. Harrison feel that niggas who carry and conservatism and shit like this and shit has any shit to do with the power structure. I guess he's talking to me, nigga wearing a wire, he say. I don't know what this shit means. Charleston white ass nigga, he say. See, B. Harrison ain't used to real ones. He like fake ones. He prefer that no snitch clause and shit, you know. That hood nigga shit, you know what I mean? Like, cats in the hood, like the conscious community ain't about no real two-way shit and self-protection. This is why a lot of them gun clubs and shit, the leaders of the gun clubs arrested and going to jail because their intent is bad. You know, this is for education and self-protection, about protecting your family and your life, being ready in case something goes down. Being of the warrior class. But these gun clubs will be on that fuck nigga shit. Their mindset is and intent is on race wars. It's a good way to get your group shut down. Is to run your shit based on race wars. There's not going to be no civil wars. All you niggas is getting locked up if you think you're going to be engaged in a civil war. Plus a civil war, you're going to catch a murder case. It's not self-protection at that point. Right? I'm talking self-protection. Not fuck nigga shit. Not shooting like when, what was it, the rapper who got shot in Memphis? And they say all his security was protecting him and was shooting back at the shooters. Like, and the whole conscious community really believed that shit. Right? I'm having to tell niggas, no. Whoever his security was, if you thought they were security, which they wasn't, they were just some fuck niggas, shooting back. They're shooting at suspects who are fleeing. They're boning out. They're leaving the scene. They're getting the fuck out of there. You cannot shoot at a fleeing suspect. Police can't even shoot at a fleeing suspect. That's called murder. No matter how much they was fucking with your homie, the rapper. If they're fleeing, you can no longer shoot. It's not self-defense at that point. It's murder. So I gotta hip you up to that shit. So you niggas know this shit. You know what I mean? So if you in the hood, you trying to think you tough and you shooting back at somebody, you can only shoot at someone to save your life. That's considered self-defense. Outside of that, it's murder. No matter if these are killers or not, if they're leaving the scene and getting away, you can't shoot them. Because you're going to catch a murder case. Just so you guys know, okay? Young Dolph was his name, I guess, Donnie Williams. And now everybody in the community was like, oh, they're shooting at a man. No, y'all better stop that shit. That's fucking murder. You guys is getting his security caught up unknowingly because you don't know gun laws and the rules. Okay, B. Harrison, you respect gun owners. Okay, so I don't know what that other stuff was about. You know what I mean? I'm the righteous one here. What you say? Little boy made sure he ain't gonna hit nobody else with the skateboard. Yeah, the dude was trying to crack Rittenhouse in the fucking face with a skateboard. That's called you're trying to knock someone unconscious. A gun owner is not going to go unconscious where you can take his gun and kill him with his own gun. It's the same thing as the black kid who the people said they was doing a citizen's arrest. Was that in Georgia? I think it was. Well, these men are caught up. So they shot the black kid with the shotgun. The black kid ran up on the motherfuckers with the shotgun and was wrestling with their shotgun. I mean, like, who with common sense is gonna let you snatch their shotgun away from them and then shoot them with it? Not going to happen. Not going to happen. Politically motivated a case. Aubrey was his name. Aubrey, if you watch his history, had another video of showing his interaction with a cop. And the nigga ran up on a cop. Like, nigga, what's up? I said, Aubrey has some mental health issues. But politically motivated cases, shit all on, niggas capping for Aubrey. B. Harris say you be capping for the system. You goddamn right. Let me tell you something, bro. The system is appropriate. Go to Ghana and you're going to see a fucked up system. You're going to see kids in orphanages not being able to get any money or being taken care of because the government don't take care of orphans in Ghana. People like me who visit and do philanthropy and donate help them kids in Ghana in the orphanage. This system is running great and appropriate. Whether you're mad at the government or not for slavery is another whole issue. This system is what other countries and third world countries are dying to have. This system is what Ghana has now. They have election systems and democratic systems now for election. They didn't have that before. Africa adopted Western world's political systems for elections because it's needed. The system is also needed for welfare for the people. Okay? So, you can be mad at the government for what it did in the 60s, 50s, 40s, and slavery and all that, but this is 2022. If you don't know America is one of the greatest countries on earth with a great working system, then there's a problem. So I'm capping for the system. If I go to Ghana right now, I have no gun rights, meaning the Ghana government can run down on the whole entire population of Ghana because the people have no gun rights. That's the problem. You have to be able to protect yourself and your family as a grown-ass, responsible man and individual in this cold world. Okay. Niggas talk that shit about this system, but nobody's leaving. Nobody's repatriating nowhere. Niggas just talking shit. And ain't going nowhere because they love it here. B. Harrison knows right now that if he loses a job or fall on hard times, he's going to be able to get some fucking food stamps so he can eat. How about that great system? Try to find that system in Africa where you lose your job and fall on hard times and the government got your back with some welfare for you. I'm just saying, juxtapose. Am I crazy? Or am I right? So, a lot of people got to get this racism out their minds. It's ruining their life. White folk ain't thinking about y'all like that. Like you guys think, white folk ain't thinking about you niggas like that. Everybody's a fucking number. In 2022. If I apply for credit or try to buy a home, nobody's gonna know I'm black. We're just a number in 2022. If I get a loan, it's based on how good my credit is, period. And my income, am I able to pay a car note or a mortgage, period. They don't give a fuck what color I am. In 2022, nobody gives a fuck what color you are. You're a number. All this race baiting shit is trash talk. I'm just as free as any fucking neighbor around me. Freer. It's not a white boy, a Mexican, a Chinese, a Japanese, a Samoan, or whoever the fuck around me who has more privilege than I do. Nope. Nope, not at all. Look here. That's y'all and your slave mind. Look here. I got a passport. I can go anywhere the fuck I want and nobody is stopping me. How am I oppressed? Is this a right-wing talking point? Or is this just the fucking truth? I got a passport. I can go anywhere in the world I want to, when I want to, and nobody stop me. I don't need to be liberated. I am liberated. I'm a free man, just like any white man, any Mexican man right now. Right now, if I want to start a toilet paper company, I can start a toilet paper company. No one is stopping me. If I want to start a hedge fund, I can start a hedge fund. Nobody is stopping me. I can run for mayor of Los Angeles. No one's stopping me. Karen Bass is running for mayor of Los Angeles and may win, and she's a black woman. We had a black police chief. We had a black president, a black attorney general. You can be what you want to be, and nobody's stopping you. You are free. You as free as any other human being on the planet. And you need to believe that. Now, these are human talking points in reality. And so what if it was a right-wing talking point? Good. All this talking point was right-wing talking point. Good. If it was left up to the Democrats, they're going to say, hey, call the police. We'll save your life. Don't worry about saving your own life, nigga. You can't have no motherfucking weapons and protect yourself in Democrat places like Baltimore, Detroit, Chicago, Los Angeles. You niggas can't protect yourself. Call us. We'll come help you. Meanwhile, the nigga that's chasing you with an axe, just keep running until we get to you. That's what the Democrats told us. Just keep running. If the guy has an axe or a bat and he's trying to cut you or knock your head off, call the police. Don't shoot him and save your life. Call the police. You better be in shape and be able to run for 30 minutes. I don't care how old you are. Call the police. We got you. Don't you worry about trying to save your own life. Call the police. That's what the Democrats told me. I don't want to give the Democrats power over my life. I'm sorry. Now, those are Democratic talking points. No, Dr. Banu, you're just a staunch Democrat because you hate Trump. I'm going to tell you, everywhere where there's failing school districts, it's a Democrat district. Trust and believe. Everywhere where the crime is the highest, it's a Democrat area. Trust and believe. I didn't make this up. That's just the reality. L.A., Chicago, Detroit, Baltimore. I mean, we crazy out here. Democrat run. New York, Democrat run. Blue as hell. I'm just saying. Oh, man, look here. So, I've been streaming for 3 hours. I've never intended to be on this long. I just wanted to give a pull-up to the pseudo cat, let them know, fuck that nigga Ankh. Pseudo killers is only two people Who's real? Corey and Chevron. Everyone else is fake as fuck. Everyone else don't have no balls. They don't stand on nothing and stay strong. Every one of the pseudo killers is scared to death of Ankh, except Corey and Jeffrey. In the beginning, they used to be kind of, I used to get on them, but they used to get mad for me getting on them, but then they started standing up to Ankh. And the coalition, I'm naming it right now. I don't care if nobody don't agree with me. The coalition is Corey, Chevron, Ngozi, Chief X, Double X, Unbiased Sports, and it's somebody else. But that's it. Them is the only ones I can trust to be 100% real. Anybody else is only going to be 90 or 80 or 70%. I'm telling you. You guys can act like you're making amends and clean shit up. It don't work with Ankh. Ankh is not the kind of person you can clean shit up with. It's only going to be 6 months from now. It's going to be some more crazy shit he's going to say. Ankh, for this entire 2 years, have been getting destroyed. I've never seen Ankh look as bad as he does in this last 2 years. I mean, this nigga's wrong about it. Everything over the last 2 years. He used to never be like that. Or maybe I just didn't realize it because I wasn't really listening to the niggas good. I think people just really wasn't listening to the nigga. That's all that it was. And we thought he was kicking some real shit. Yeah, so like you said, Donnie, it's also a character issue. It's a behavior issue. It's a mental health issue. It's a combination of things. So I just listed the men who is the realest that I know out here on. Oh, I forgot to mention Aku. 8 niggas. Outside them 8, I don't know nobody else who's just 100% real. Everybody else got an agenda. Now, if you wanted to bring a Christian on board, Pastor Bennett is perfect. I like Pastor Bennett. Okay, y'all. So, you know, I'm out of here. I'm going to end this broadcast. Y'all be cool. Peace out.